Hi, my name is Megan Atuble, and I come here from LUMOplay. I am doing an exhibit right behind you that showcases a number of different interactive displays. And today I want you to walk away with the confidence to make an interactive floor or wall all by yourself in your school using equipment that your school already has. A little bit about me, I am on the spectrum. I am a huge projector nerd. My mom was a special needs teacher, and the reason that I got into this is because my mom and my co-founder's moms really wanted to have interactive projections in their classrooms. And at the time, this was about 15, 16 years ago, we looked into it and it was about $40,000 a system, which is not something a school can afford. So we started developing software that teachers could create their own interactive displays with using equipment that the school already had. I have over 20 years of experience making interactive projection stuff. I never planned to get into this industry, but here we are. And I really want to help you. We gave our software away for free for the first 5 years because we really believe in making this available for classrooms. We have now a free version as well as an at-cost version because we found that there were so many schools that were using it for 4 or 5 plus years at a time that we needed to start charging in order to host the software. But we're still very committed to making sure that the price of the software is affordable for schools and that the price will remain at cost for schools. The most common question that I get asked by teachers is whether or not it's hard to do this. There are a few steps that you need to go through. You'll need to find the equipment, so you'll need to unearth a projector that your school is not using. You need to order what you don't have, which means that you'll need to do a little bit of research to make sure that you're getting the equipment that you need. You need to install some things. You'll need to be able to drill holes, so you might have to ask permission to do this. And you'll need to maintain the system. The most maintenance that you'll need to do is about 20 minutes every month cleaning the filters, and that's if you're running it all the time and it's really dirty. Most of the time it's 20 minutes to 30 minutes a year. The next most common question I get asked is it expensive to do this? The average cost for everything you need brand new is about $2,500 US if you're buying a brand new computer, a brand new projector, and all of your mounting hardware. Most of the time you already have what you need, and the only thing that a school is going to need to buy is a 3D camera, which is about $200. You probably already have the most expensive part, which is the projector. So here's a little bit of information about projectors so that you can identify what your school has and decide what you can use and how you can use it. A long throw or fixed lens projector is the most common projector for a school to have, and it has a slightly smaller lens and is designed to sit a little bit of a ways back from your wall. If you're going to use this kind of projector, then it's going to need to be at least 8 to 10 feet from the surface, and it's ideal for floor projection. A short throw is great for floor or wall projection because it creates a bigger image from a shorter distance, and it has a big bubble lens, so they're very obvious. And an ultra short throw, which you can see in my portable system as well as my wall system in the demo that I'm giving, looks really unique and bounces the light off of a mirror. And as a result, you can have it much closer to the surface. The brightness of the projector is directly related to the price. So if you can control the lighting in the environment where you're putting the system in, it's going to bring your price down quite a bit. You'll need about 100 to 2500 lumens in a room where you can turn the lights off. And you can get these projectors for $500 new, sometimes even less. A regular classroom lighting, which is a little bit dimmer than in this trade show environment, 2,500 to 4,000 lumen projector will be perfect. And if you're going to do something in a school gym or an auditorium, somewhere with brighter lighting like this kind of environment, then you'll probably need a brighter projector, which is going to run you about $2,500 new. The cost increases with the brightness. So if you can control the lighting in your environment, it's going to bring the cost down a lot. You also need a computer with these specs. Basically, it's a gaming computer. All of this information is available on our website, so don't memorize it. It's easy to find. And you will need a 3D camera. The 3D camera must be long range. It has to be compatible with the software that you're using, and they run about $150 plus. You'll need mounts and cables to attach all of the equipment, and you will need a surface to project on. So if your floor is very patterned or very dark, you'll most likely need light gray matte vinyl to project on. If you're doing a wall, then any light colored wall will work. Screen goo paint is very, very good for walls. So if you have a less bright projector and you're willing to coat the wall with projection paint, Screen Goo Systems is a really good opportunity for you to use a less bright projector and just optimize the image with paint. There's a few different software platforms that you can use if you want to make an interactive experience. So aside from what we offer, which is LUMOplay, and it's a subscription you pay every year per system, we've got some limitations. It only runs on Windows. There's not really any coding. We do have a Unity SDK, but most teachers don't teach Unity at an elementary school level. So making the games does not involve any code. If you want to make something custom for your classroom, it's really easy to do. As long as you can upload an image to Facebook, you can use our software to make your own games. It ships with about 350 games, so there's games right out of the box. And the tutorials for the templates are really easy to follow. So there's a lot of documentation about how to use this software. And like I said, it's been in the market for over 15 years. It's really, really well documented. But it's only for interactive floors and walls. You can do tables with it, people have done windows with it, but it doesn't do the things that Touch Designer does. If you want to make an interactive experience that uses a lot of different sensors, if you want to use this in a STEM class, if you want everything to be about learning how to code, Touch Designer is a really good option. And if you're working with very little children and you don't have the ability to install a large interactive display, I want to recommend Tagtool. It's a program that you can get for an iPad, very, very affordable. It's not interactive in the same way that LUMOplay is, where it reacts to a camera, but children can draw on an iPad and then animate what they draw and bring it to life through projection, which is equally magical and very engaging. And again, the cost can't be beat. So in conclusion, if you want to do this, you need a projector, a computer, a camera, and some kind of software. And you might have to order some stuff. Most likely you're gonna have to order the camera. It will take a few hours for you to set this up. And you will probably need help, so you should write down my contact information. Thank you. It was great to meet you. If you have any questions, you can come see me at my booth.